Hey everyone, welcome to the show. And today the guest with me is a budding doctor. He's a final year student at Grant Medical College studying in Mumbai, Deevya Parekh. Hey Deevya, welcome to the show.
Thank you, it's good to be here.
Being a doctor, the way I look at it, it's a calling. So tell me, how early did you find out that this was it for you?
I decided I wanted to be a doctor all the way back in like the third grade.
Wow.
And actually I have an older cousin brother who's 2 years elder than me, and he also wanted to be a doctor. And then like he made a last minute change and he went into engineering.
And he was stuck.
No, but I've always wanted to do this. Sure, I've loved it all the way.
Wow, because I've heard this a lot from people that, you know, the ones that want to become a doctor are pretty much sure and the rest of the world is undecided. You always had the choice in front of you of studying in India or going abroad. Was that always a choice for you, or were you very clear you wanted to study in India?
The thing is, I was quite definite on having this, doing my medicine in India because of the time difference that it makes. But the mistake I actually made back then is in the 8th, when you have to choose between ICSE and IGCSE,
right?
I picked IGCSE, which is the Cambridge one.
Okay.
So at that point, it was a hassle to convert grades into an Indian percentage.
Okay, so you're calling it a mistake because ideally, looking back, you're saying you should have studied in the Indian, whether it's ICSE or perhaps CBSE or one of the Indian boards up to 10th grade, and then continue in the Indian board. And because you switched to the Cambridge board, the switch back to the Indian board after 10th is where you had a challenge.
Yeah, so now these conversions are easily available because people do it a lot.
Okay.
And the ICSE marks come out a good like 2 months before IGCSE actually gives you the grades.
Yes.
So I got lucky that there was an SSE court case going on which dragged the whole admission procedure further.
Okay.
So like I could afford to wait for my final marks grades, and then have them converted.
Yeah. Okay. So, when you say the reason you chose the Indian system for the time advantage, so coming back to the program that you do, how long is this MBBS undergraduate program?
So the MBBS program in India after the 12th is 5.5 years, of which actually 4.5 years are studying,
right,
and 1 year is a compulsory internship that you have to do at the hospital at which you're studying.
Okay.
And in comparison abroad, it would be the whole pre-med and then you go to med school, which is the 4.5 years.
Oh, okay.
So you have that big time saved.
So you have like 8.5 years if you were somewhere there, if you were in the US versus 5.5 when you're here. Okay, so what would you recommend for a student wanting to study medicine? What is your strong recommendation about, apart from the time, studying in India versus studying in another country?
It depends actually on where you plan to practice after.
Right.
But if you're undecided or you're planning to practice in India, then studying in India makes the most sense because, as I told you, the time difference is already significant. And also, there's a very important subject called community medicine.
Right.
And all the cases that you see are very endemic to India. They're very specific. So the experience that you get studying in India helps you like so much to practice in India, which is something you would not get abroad.
Right.
Because there's a different spectrum in the kind of diseases you see.
Yeah, so the bacterial diseases in India
probably. Yeah, so more infectious diseases here. People of lower socioeconomic background compared to affluency abroad. So even though it's a 5.5 year course, by name of the year, technically it's 3 years. First year is just a 1 year course where you're learning normal functioning, so normal structures, processes and everything in the body, and you have dissections and things to do. Second year is actually a year and a half.
Okay.
And second year is regarding what causes disease and what are the disease processes and the drugs that counter it.
Okay.
And third year is 2 years. It's over 2 years.
Okay.
Where your first year is called third minor.
Okay.
And the second year is called final year.
Okay.
And most of your, like, the main important stuff comes in final year crammed together. So final year is easily the most hectic year.
Oh, okay. And which is what, where you are right now.
What I just started.
And where does the internship fit in?
No, the internship is compulsory after you pass your final year exams.
Okay.
And the whole point of the compulsory internship is that they've provided you education at their government institution for a much lower cost than what others private institutions would. So to get something back from you, you're doing an internship as working for them for that year for very minimal village.
Right, right. And of which some bit, I understand, has to be in the rural areas, etc.
Yeah, so generally you should have a month and a half or 2 years of rural internship at a place in Maharashtra.
Okay, this, just tell me this 5.5 year program and 1 year you're working out. Now, of this, is this largely at the classroom or is there sort of a practical aspect to it as well?
So, the first year, you have a lot of lectures, but you also have a lot of practicals in the sense that you're working with dissections and things in the lab, but not at a ward in the hospital.
Okay.
But from second year onward, which is really early, you can attend the wards and you can go to the medicine department, surgery department, where you don't have that much to do. You have like an observing role.
Right.
And then the 2 years of third year, you get posted immediately to the wards.
Okay.
And the difference in the Indian system compared to others is that we don't really have dummies for people to learn on.
Right.
So as soon as you start final year, you get like immediately thrown into it like you're a doctor. Everything is to be done for you. You have a bed patient and it's like kind of on you.
Wow.
So, it's a really good experience.
That's like a mock. You're doing an evaluation before the doctor really comes in?
Yeah, that's the thing. So you take the history, the examination and everything. And then when the doctor comes, you can explain to him your case, but then that's your bed case. You get immediately thrown into it to learn on a live patient.
One of the other common objections that people worry about when they have to study in India is the possibility of perhaps having large class sizes and less interaction with the professors. So how does that work for you?
So to an extent that's correct, because that's a difference in the education system here and abroad, that a lot of our classes are kind of like lectures, which are a little more imposed learning compared to an open discussion. But barring lectures, anything where you have to practically see or do anything like dissections or lab work or tutorials, you get broken down into smaller batches of 20, 10 or 20. So there's not as much of a problem as large groups, which is only limited to lectures.
So one of the things that students tell me they find ominous about the prospect of studying in India is the challenge of clearing the entrance exams. So, tell us a bit about how difficult that is.
You have two entrance exams to get into medical colleges. One is the Maharashtra CET.
Right.
And you have an All India exam, which is for states from outside Maharashtra to be applicable to come to Maharashtra colleges.
Okay.
So, CET is you give the exam at the end of your 12th.
Right.
And it's an extremely competitive exam. You have students in lakhs giving the exam.
Okay.
And the good medical institutions here, to join one of them, you'd have to rank in the top 500.
Whoa.
So, okay. It's extremely tough. So the thing is, from the start, you have to have made up your mind that you want to achieve that goal.
Right.
And you have to have picked your subject coaching classes correctly. But from halfway through the 11th till the end, you have to have a good level of sustained study to reach that level to achieve a rank. So it's a lot of hard work.
It's a lot of work. So what kind of coaching classes? Do you have any recommendation there?
You pick the classes based on your location, actually, because a lot of the thing is time management. Need to get optimum work done, but it's very important to pick coaching classes which are specific to the common entrance test and not just the general 12th standard college. And early on from the start, they take weekly tests which are graded, and they like print out a mark sheet. You need a parent sign and everything.
Tell me one more thing. You said Maharashtra entrance exam. Does it allow anybody to apply for it, or do you necessarily have to have lived in Maharashtra for a certain number of years?
You have to have lived in Maharashtra for a specific amount of years.
Okay.
They have some government specific guidelines which you have to match those criteria to be applicable for it.
So for a student who's perhaps a parent is in a transferable job and has lived for a couple of years in different states of the country, how does the MBBS entrance exam work?
So there's an All India exam,
right?
Which as long as you're an Indian citizen, you can give. So it's not state specific, and the advantage of that is that that exam is applicable to medical colleges of all states.
Okay.
So having given that exam, you have the widest range of options to go to if you're willing to move.
Okay. And there you could possibly go to then any state. But if you want to be in the state that you've lived in for a longest period of time, then it's probably advisable to go for that state. CET is how you're saying
it. That's right.
Okay, so you decided really early, but I'm looking at a high school student, perhaps in grade 6, 7, trying to decide, should I go IGCSE, should I study Indian curriculum, and there's a plethora of subjects, there are combinations of subjects and all of that available. So what's your advice to that student in terms of choosing the right subjects, etc.?
So I feel like you have to have made a decision by the end of your 7th grade before the 8th standard, because not only is it really important to pick ICSE over IGCSE if you plan to study here, it's also important that given the option, you have to have picked all three sciences split rather than a coordinated course. So the format of the common entrance test is that every student who gives it has to give physics and chemistry.
Right.
You have to give it.
Right.
Then those are 50-50 marks, and you have 100 marks for math,
okay,
which you would give if you're moving to engineering,
right,
and 100 marks for biology, which you give, which allows you to apply to medicine, dentistry, and also pharmacy.
Okay. Okay. So the same scores of physics, chemistry plus biology are used by the medical colleges, dental colleges, and pharmacy colleges.
Yeah.
And in the pecking order, the sort of top ranked students are chosen by the medical colleges. Is that how it is?
Yeah. So there's a system where you have to submit a sheet based on your order of preference of institutions,
okay,
and a computer matches you.
Okay.
But generally, a much lower rank compared to medicine would allow you to get into a decent place in dentistry or pharmacy, because most people who do it are actually aiming towards medicine.
Okay.
And then see you.
And tell me, there are private colleges within, say, if I look at within Maharashtra, there are private colleges, there are government colleges. So do you get to choose where you want to go and how?
Yeah, you get to choose. Some private hospitals have their own entrance test, which is separate from CET. But the major difference is that being in a government hospital, so you see a lot more patients.
Okay.
So in dissection in first year, you get an ample amount of cadavers, and your clinical experience in a government hospital is very good. You'd see a lot of patients. And on the flip side, if you go to a private hospital, you have great teaching staff.
Right.
Your level of education is high, but you see much fewer patients.
So what would you recommend to a student if they had to choose?
Generally, everyone in the top ranks would pick a government hospital,
right,
because at the end of the day, clinical experience is something that cannot be substituted.
You were watching part one of a two-part video series titled How to Become a Doctor. Look out for part two, where Deevya Parekh talks of postgraduate studies, comparison between studying in India and abroad, cost comparisons, the process of application, whether an Indian doctor can work abroad, vacations, one lesson learnt, future plans, social life, and a fun experience. Stay tuned and happy watching. Please click the subscribe button below. Like me at facebook.com/chetchat101. Follow my Twitter handle, chetchat101, or at Instagram, chetchat101. Please leave your comments in the sections below. And if you'd like me to feature any particular college, please let me know. Thank you.